see. Ryan, thank you so much in Chicago. And if you went to the store this weekend, you probably saw empty shelves, long lines. Just check out this line at a Costco in Marina Del Rey, California. People were there snatching up everything from canned goods to meat, toilet paper, paper towels. That, those have been gone a lot of places where people are looking for them. President Trump relayed the message this weekend from the grocery industry, urging people not to panic and not to panic buy. Our Vanessa Yurkevich is at a store in New York, and tell us about the message that you're hearing on the supply chain overall, Vanessa.
Hi, Brianna. Well, the supply chain is definitely slowed, but not stopped. There is no food shortage. It's just taking a little bit longer for the supply to catch up with the demand. So what we're seeing here is deliveries that came in early this morning that are still waiting to make their way onto the empty shelves inside of this Morton Williams grocery store here in Manhattan. But another thing that they're concerned about is people feeling safe inside the store. They want to make sure that when people are shopping that they're feeling safe. If you take a look in there, the lines are snaking through the store right now, and it's not necessarily following CDC guidelines of being around 50 people or less. There's well over 50 people in the store. So stores are now cleaning hourly. They're disinfecting the handles of the freezer section. They're disinfecting shopping carts. They're disinfecting the keypads that you're going to be making your purchases on. But they're also asking shoppers to take note of how they're feeling. Make sure that if you're not feeling well, please do not come into the grocery store as you're in close quarters with others. They're asking employees also, if employees are feeling sick, please call out sick and don't come into the store today. But obviously, Brianna, you know, this is a very sort of strange and unknown and uncertain time. People need food, but at the same time, people are trying as best they can to follow these social distancing requirements. But Brianna, as you can imagine, it's looking like it's very difficult to follow both those rules right now, Brianna.
Yeah.